What's going on, guys? This is Kaisha. Welcome back. We are back with another video. On this video, we're going to cover the Uncrowned Kings Local Metagame Report video that will cover tournament results and decklist reviews for the past 2 weeks. We have May 15 to May 31. So, a bit late, no? But, yeah, better late than never. So, we are going to see a lot of tournament results and data here from May 15 to May 31. So, yeah, concluding the April format of the OCG. Before we go into our new ban list this July. So yeah, forgive me if I haven't uploaded informative content for the past couple of days because I have been busy. Especially the WCQ Philippines have been concluded and I have been very busy on that and stressed a lot as well. So yeah, we are going to assimilate the decks here. Moving on the Azrak Season 9 Top 16 deck list. So this is a very popular online tournament in the Philippines with the Azrak. So, on first place, we have Tonea Vergara with her Snake Eyes Influence Spoils. So, yeah, very standard decklist of Snake Eyes, no? Just the standard amount of Snake Eyes cards with 3 Poplar and, of course, the 3 Diabel Star. And also, I play the Magician Soul, which can be very strong and can definitely improve the resiliency and consistency of the Snake Eyes without the Finsmith, of course. This is the original build and a standard way to play Snake Eyes. Aside from the Finsmith engine, and also played double talent, no? So, very good card in the Philippine setup because there's a lot of Tenpai, and Tenpai Dragon is very dominant and very much played in our local metagame scene. So, talent can definitely answer bunch of hand traps like Droll, Ogre, and Veiler, no? And also, Multichami as well has a play on her side deck. So, Multichami can be quite tricky, no? Because most people are preferring things like Droll, Nibiru, and Ghost Ogre, even Phantasmi. So, Multichami are kinda overshadowed by those cards. But yeah, I still think that Multichami can definitely give you so much advantages when you have the correct phase to use this card. And you can pretty much guarantee a lot of draws and even a mulligan for your deck. And next, we have second place, Tenpai Good Stuff, no? So, very interesting build from Alfred Zamora. This Tenpai has the capability to go first with the Olayon package and the Aurora Dawn, no? So he has plays to go first, even if his opponent lets you go first, and it is a very notable weakness of Tenpai, where they will go first and pretty much end up on nothing aside from the Hieratic Seals pass. So he has avenues to play even his opponent lets him go first. And on the side deck, there's a bunch of extra deck cards with the Summer Destroyer and Striker Dragon and also the Super Poly Targets. Very interesting deck build from Alfred Zamora. Next, we have Cedric Joshua Flores. We have Yubel Unchained, no? So, quite different from the usual Yubel with Finsmith, no? So, this time with Unchained. So, yeah, kinda generic build of Yubel Unchained. Very punctual, very effective from Cedric. And, yeah, it is notable that he played a lot of going second cards on this build on his side deck. We have Droll, Pankratops, the Duster and Heavy Storm with triple Dark Ruler No More with triple Cosmic Cyclone. So yeah, I think that this deck kinda struggles when going second. Sometimes some boards are too huge for this deck to overcome. So you have to have cards like Droll and Dark Ruler No More that guarantees you a lot of passages to play around boards of your opponent and prevent it from overwhelming you. And next, we have Infernoble Knight from Ivanhoe Evangelista. So another interesting deck here. We have Infernoble Knight, a very combo-ish deck, no? Nothing to say too much on this deck, just a type of combo deck that overwhelms you when it can go first. You set up a lot of negations, interruptions, and yeah, pretty much about it. On the side deck, it played a small amount package of Sinful Spoils. Very interesting. So you just want to capitalize on the original and yeah, let's your play going on. And next, we have Voiceless Voice from Paul Ordonio, our friend from Kaidu Willis. So yeah, standard build of Voiceless Voice, nothing too fancy here. Just played one copy of Nibiru and one talent on the main deck. And also, yeah, Called by the Grave and Cross Out. I haven't seen this in quite a while, no? So Called by, Cross Out, those cards are very strong to answer the Tenpai, especially using Voiceless Voice, which can be very problematic when you're going to face a bunch of hand traps. So yeah, Called by and Cross Out really makes a lot of sense here. Next, we have Anan Kipit from Atagig using Labyrinth, so Attrap heavy variant of Labyrinth with the Backjack, no, and Dogmatica Punishment. So he just wants to flourish his going first capability using these various of trap cards, which are very tremendous when going first. And also triple Phantasmia as well. I think this has been his answer towards the link based format. We have Rescue Ace, Snake Eyes, and Finsmith, bunch of link based decks. So Phantasmia really made a huge contribution here on his side deck. Next we have Fire King Snake Eyes in response from Walter Fat. So yeah, played one droplet and one talent on the main deck. Very odd ratio of cards, but yeah, it's rather effective because you can pretty much capitalize on talent on the format due to the various hand traps and droplet as well. Can be very good against Voiceless Voice and Jubel. So yeah, triple Didicrow as well, no? Didicrow has been seeing a lot of rise in popularity recently because Didicrow can be very strong against Voiceless Voice, can be decent against Tenpai, can be also okay against the Snake Eyes. So it is very versatile right now. Next we have Chimera Jubel from our friend and Kaido Willis, Karasu Elite Team member. We have Joshua Coriano with Chimera Jubel. So nothing too extravagant on this build. Very standard, very punctual, very efficient build of Chimera Jubel. And yeah, I think Chimera is still a very good deck in the format right now. Can pretty much overwhelm a lot of decks, even going second. You have a lot of gas and you have a very powerful board going first, especially with the Dark Warrior statue and also the Jubel package on this deck. Next, we have another Jubel. So there's a bunch of Jubel already. We have Jubel Unchained, top 16. And yeah, kinda streamlined deck build as well of Jubel Unchained. And this time it played, yeah, the, oh, it doesn't play the Finsmith, so yeah, just another Jubel Unchained. And yeah, it played a lot of going second cards on the side. We have Double Trust with one Soul Release, a very good card to answer the Snake Eyes. And triple Change of Heart with double Evenly goodness. And next we have Synchro Naturi Horus. Wow, very interesting. A 60 card pile of combo, bunch of extenders deck. With the Horus, I think it complements the Naturia, of course, with the Horus package. We all knew how the interaction works on the graveyard setup of those Naturia cards, fathering from the Horus cards. And yeah, it does have a lot of hand trap as well, even though it has a 60 card variation. So we are very original in a sense that you don't see this deck every day. And on the side deck, it played Battle Fader. Yeah, Battle Fader just to answer the Tenpai, of course. And next we have Tenpai Dragon from Banjo. So yeah, quite odd and kinda outdated build of Tenpai, no? Considering the fact that Blaster have been ditched from many Japanese Tenpai decklist right now. And played Ghost Spooky Dogwood. Yeah, can be very strong on time rules. And next we have Chimera Horus from Renzigzagan. So yeah, another Chimera Horus. But yeah, this time it has Horus. It doesn't have Jubel. So yeah, just a standard Chimera Horus. And Wanghu Tiger, wow. On the side deck, a very interesting tech for the Chimera. So Wanghu Tiger can definitely shut down a lot of decks on the format right now. And next we have Inferno Bell, Sinful Spoil. So another Inferno Bell, no? So I wonder what's going on with the Inferno Bell builds. But yeah, it's rather successful right now from Juan Joseph Lipana. And next we have another Tenpai Dragon from Gio Agoto. This time, it played Multi-Chami Triple Capacity on the main deck. So he just wants to capitalize on draw power with the Maxi and the Multi-Chami. So you get a lot of draw from that and it definitely stacks on those two cards and you get ridiculous amounts of card advantages. Next, we have another Tenpai Dragon. Wow. So, this is what I am saying earlier. There's a bunch of Tenpai Dragon in the Philippines. Not only it is cost-efficient, you can pretty much get the deck for a cheap price point, and it is very strong. I cannot deny that. And we have Memento Tlan from Renz Carlo Pongo. So, another interesting deck on the format right now. Most people are not yet sold on defeating this deck, and most people are still trying to find ways on how to stop the Memento Tlan, and including me, I still think that this deck is still unexplored and uncharted on a sense that it can be better if players and pilots will pick up this deck and use this on high tier events. And yeah, moving on, we have Davao Mindanao Gaming Ranking Tournament. First place, we have, yeah, Tenpai Good Stuff. I think it's the same list as earlier, so we won't ponder on it too much. But yeah, same pilot, same deck, same recipe, just a different tournament from Alfred. And next, we have Synchron WoW. So another Synchron, no? So yeah, we are going to see a lot of combo decks here on our report from Lee Mervin Muiko Synchron. So we have a bunch of Synchro cards that can definitely shut down the opponent from the moment that you have seen Barone, Dispatter, Crystal Clearwing, and yeah, a bunch of those Omni Negate threats on your board. You are pretty much going to win the game one once you go first and you're not interrupted. And wow, look at this. Since when did I have Mirror Force? Wow, Mirror Force. Imagine that. Mirror Force in 2024. So yeah, another answer to Tenpai, rather. And moving on, we have another Davao Ranking Tournament. We have first place here, Yubel. So yeah, it doesn't have Vin Smith, no? So just the usual Yubel with Fiend Targets and Fiend Link Shenanigans. And yeah, I played Triple Ghost Ogre. You would rather see Ogre against Tenpai. You pretty much need to out the field spell and also Prohibition, yeah. So yeah, maybe he just wants to cancel out Droll and other threats on his playthrough. And next we have Jobel vs Tenpai Dragon. So yeah, standard Tenpai, no? Nothing too extravagant. It played Super Poly in the main deck. Super Poly is very strong on the Tenpai mirror match and very strong as well on the meta, considering that we still have Voiceless Voice and Yubel. And yeah, we have, oh, we still have third place Tenpai Dragon from Warren Lloyd. So we this time with Chicken Game, very interesting. And also Forbidden Kalis, very spicy from Warren. I think these decks are very unconventional. You pretty much don't see Kalis on Tenpai. Next we have Clarky Maturan Tenpai Dragon. So this time it played Kaiser Colosseum on the main deck, so he has options to floodgate the opponent. And also a bunch of going first cards. His side deck is pretty much centered around going first cards with the Heatwave, Necro Valley, the barrier, so he just wants to safely go first when his opponents lets him go first. Next, we have another ranking tournament from Davao Mindanao Gaming. Another tournament, we have Chester, we have Orcus Horus Bestial. So this is a very TCG-esque build of Horus, no, with Bestial. So this time with Orcus, of course, very powerful deck, considering that Horus is a good discard fodder for the Orcus. You pretty much get value from your Harp and Orcus cards on the graveyard with the World Kalis shenanigans and stuff. You pretty much know about it. So yeah, it's a very insane deck. And next we have Goblin Biker. Wow, Goblin Biker. This is very interesting. I often see Goblin Biker on AE, Asian English tournaments, but not in the OCG, because Goblin Biker inherently counters the Purely, which is a very notable deck on AE format right now. But your Goblin Biker on OCG is not your everyday cup of tea. So yeah, it has Kagemucha and Danger Package and a bunch of level 3 access going towards the rank 3 axis of this deck. And on the side deck, it played, wow, very interesting cards. I would rather don't know the name of these cards. Yeah, very spicy from Carl Joseph Saikon. And next, we have another Davao Mindanao Gaming Ranking Tournament. We have first place Jobel vs Tenpai Dragon. So this time it played Double Fadra on the main deck. So Double Fadra is a debate for Tenpai players. Tenpai players are arguing whether they would play 1 Fadra or 2 Fadra. But for me, I would rather see 1 Fadra on the deck, because yeah, it's a brick on certain occasions and 1 is enough. But sometimes there are times that you need the second copy, and those times can be very hard to deal against, especially Tenpai is very limited on certain resources and you need to procure your place using the color of the dragons on your side of the field. So yeah, next we have Farking Snake Eyes Fiend Smith. So yeah, very modern approach for the Snake Eyes with Fiend Smith, no? So Fiend Smith really elevates your Snake Eyes game, because you have avenues to divert your place going to Snake Eyes and shifting towards the link to Underworld Goddess of the card here on the extra deck going into the Finsmith package. So it is very versatile, it is very strong, it is very consistent. There's a lot of ways that you can go into using this deck, and it's not a joke because this has a lot of gas, and most decks cannot interrupt this deck into submitting them. And decks like Tenpai, Voiceless Voice doesn't have too much gas to play around this deck. Next, we have another Davao Mindanao Gaming Ranking Tournament. We have Harold Kase Metabeat, no? So, the good old Metabeat. Yeah, it is a very, what do you call this? Extravagant feeling to see Metabeat because it is a direct counter against the meta, of course. The Metabeat itself is a word that defines, that counters the meta. So yeah, I played triple metaverse, and yeah, I don't really see his cards here. Triple clockwork, no? And double duality with double demise. So just the right amount of draw power. And yeah, I have seen the Necro Valley. Of course, Necro Valley is very strong against the meta. And next we have Parking Snake Eyes Finsmith. So I think it's the same list as earlier, yeah, with Andro Aguinaldo. And moving on, we have Order of the Duelist and Albay Ranking Tournament. We have Champion Mark Stephen, Snake Eyes Finsmith. So standard, yeah, very standard build from Mark Stephen, another friend from the Kai Duelist community. We double Droll, no? So Droll is very prominent right now in the format, mainly to stop the combo decks from playing. Of course, the Finsmith, you need to have answers against the Finsmith. Next, we have Unchained Finsmith from Ellie. So yeah, Unchained definitely benefited from the Finsmith because those are Fiend. It's not a question because it definitely complements the Unchained, and you have more explosiveness for this Unchained, and you pretty much guarantee to make explosive plays and better going second avenue using the Finsmith line. And also we have Tenpai, another Tenpai with a bunch of going second cards on the deck. We have triple Droplet, double Lightning Storm, one Duster on the main deck. Next we have Light Swarms. Wow, Light Swarms with Infernoid. Yeah, it has Infernoid and it has Snake Eyes. Wow, this is very interesting. I'm not sure if it is Light Sworn because I don't see Light Sworn cards. Yeah, maybe it is incorrect, no? It is just Infernoid with Snake Eyes. And yeah, moving on, we have Arcanium Habis Ranking Tournament. We have first place Horus Thunder Dragon with Bestials. So, Thunder Dragon have been quite sleeper, no? Considering the fact that the meta always adds 4 cards for days, so Dex likes to opt to draw and of course add cards from the deck towards the hand. So Colossus is a card to answer that mechanic. And also with Horus and Bestials, the deck have been more explosive and resilient. You have more plays to play using the Bestial package and Horus. And next we have Mementotlan. So standard, yeah, very standard double Imperm only on the main deck. And yeah, I played double Ghost Ogre and Diddy Crow, which can be good against Voiceless Voice and Tenpai. Next we have another Finsmith Unchained. Yeah, Finsmith Unchained with 51 card. Wow, 51 card, imagine that. With triple Trust and double Talent on the main deck, of course you would rather see your Trust to fetch off your trap cards and spell cards. And Kuripoton, another interesting card right now on the side deck of this player Indra. So yeah, Kuripoton definitely shut down Tenpai. And next we have another Memento. And yeah, I played Ghost Bell, another alternative similar function towards the Diddy Crow. You need to stop the graveyard interactions of your opponent right now. And yeah, moving on, we have Yu-Gi-Oh! Davao Mindanao Gaming. So yeah, it's the same list as earlier, no? From Alfred Zamora, he has been tapping tournaments, multiple tournaments using the same build. And next we have Mikanko. Wow, Mikanko. I am lost for words for this deck because this deck is very hassle. Yeah, that's the correct term to describe this deck. It is a hassle to play against Mikanko, and it's very, yeah, unsettling feeling. So Mekanco definitely has rooms to cater the format right now. Can be decent against Ayubel. I even don't know how the interaction with Ayubel and Mekanco cards happen. I'm not really sure. So let me know in the comments if you know the interactions using the Battle Phase shenanigans of Ayubel and Mekanco. So yeah, Prime Cruise play triple Dogwood. Maybe the tempo of Mekanco is rather slow, so you want to win on time using the Dogwood. And yeah, moving on, we have Osiris Dubilis ranking tournament. We have first place Tenpai. So Tenpai with Sangen Kaiho on the main deck from Adit, no? So very interesting. So he has options to play the Sangen Kaiho on the main deck, and his opponents lets him go first, so he has no issues. He can play this card. You can search it from Pydra. And yeah, a bunch of hand traps as well on the main deck. Next, we have another Ayubel Finsmith. So Ayubel Finsmith have been seeing a lot of play recently. And yeah, it's no wonder because it's one of the top 5 best decks in my opinion right now. And next we have, wow, look at this beauty. We have Melodious Lightsworn with Finsmith. Very interesting. So a bunch of engines that meshes well together. So you mill 4 cards using the Lightsworn, you combo off using the Pendulum cards of Melodious, and of course the Finsmith engine with no restrictions or whatsoever. Very insane and oppressive kind of engine right now. And next we have Voiceless Voice, a standard version of Voiceless Voice played. There can be only one on the side deck, and Double Bestials, interesting choice. Maybe he has worries against the mirror match, and can be good against the, of course, light and dark attributes on the graveyard. And yeah, moving on, we have Duels Debata ranking tournament. We have first place Tenpai from Umbo. Yeah, it played Regeki on the main deck, a very interesting card on the Tenpai main deck. You don't really cost too much, unlike the droplet. You need to send cards, of course, and Regeki does the job well done on certain decks that doesn't have Omni Negate on their board. And yeah, triple Kaiju, no? So he preferred Kaiju over Santa Claus. I would rather see the same as well, because Santa Claus gives the opponent a draw. So yeah, it's kinda risky if you cannot finish the opponent off. And next we have another Ayubel Finsmith from Prana. So there's a bunch of Ayubel Finsmith already, and I'm getting tired of seeing Ayubel. But this time it played standard version as well with double draw on the main deck. Next we have Dynamorphia. So yeah, Dynamorphia with a bunch of counter traps with Solemn Judgment and of course the Thunderhammer on the side deck. With triple appointer, no, I think it's correct because you need to be wary of Lava Golems, of the Kaijus, of the Santa Claus, and other cards that may hurt your setup, like Evenly Matched, that anti-spell fragrance cannot be answered. So yeah, it played anti-spell on the main deck. We double Wannabe. So yeah, Wannabe is a good card to fetch off trap cards. And next we have, wow, Earth Machine. So this report is getting crazy with a bunch of rogue decks, interesting decks, and pile decks, no? This time we have Earth Machine, so a very competitive deck. When going second, you can pretty much OTK every time. And the only concern would be going first, because he doesn't play the Valdrat, yeah, on the extra deck. So yeah, I wonder how he approaches the going first, or he just go to blind second all the time. And next we have Bandung Dubilis Balis, local tournament. We have first place Alel, Snake Eyes Finsmith. So standard version of Snake Eyes, played Celine with the Beatrice, of course, standard extra deck cards. And also triple Nibiru, no? So he didn't play Ghost Ogre. Yeah, he didn't play Ghost Ogre. And also Phantasmi and also Bell. So he is confident with Nibiru to stop the mirror match and also the other combo decks variants on the format right now. Next we have Jinang, Voiceless Voice. So it played the new Ash Blossom trap card, they said, no? So yeah, I have been seeing a surge of inclusions of this card recently on the previous reports, especially last week. On the last week of May and the first week of June right now. So yeah, this is very interesting. It is a potential meta changing card where people can experiment this and use this as another option to hand trap the opponent. So we're going to see the advancements of this inclusion on the following weeks. But right now, it's good as tech card only. Next, we have Unchained Finsmith, so another Finsmith deck. So yeah, standard triple tour guide and one Fiendish Rhino, and played triple debarrier on the side deck. Some people often play Solemn Judgment to protect their board, but yeah, the debarrier also can be very phenomenal against Tenpai. Next, we have, speaking of the devil, we have Tenpai Dragon with triple Dogwood, no? So yeah, can be good against Tenpai rather, because you gain life points, but yeah, you can still get OTK'd from the Trident Dragon, so it's a high risk play using the Dogwood. And yeah, that sums up our Uncrowned Kings Local Metagame Report video for our May 15 to May 31 issue. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you do learn something from it, and please drop a like and subscription on my YouTube channel, and definitely keeps me motivated. So once again, thank you for watching. See you on the next one. Peace.